pair of shoes. So now, but there are many other children who are deprived from completing their wishes, and they used to or they have to suffer their life in this scarce conditions, in this rough conditions, which is very, very hard to imagine. My acquaintance with the barefoot. Acquaintance means familiar. My acquaintance means jankari, my known. When we become familiar with each other, with barefoot rag pickers leads me to Simhapuri, and these children had taken me to their main place where their home belongs to. It is a part of Delhi, the border area of Delhi, that is known as Simhapuri, a place on the periphery of Delhi. Periphery means the border of Delhi, yet miles away from it. Metaphorically, those who live here are squatters who came from Bangladesh back in 1971. Squatters means that they are illegally living in this type of area. Actually, they had built up slums, they had built up their tin sheds type of houses, which is made of iron rods, woods, which is illegally, which is not registered. These are taken by the dominance, by they do not have actually any place to live. So what they did, they found as a place very bordered, and they just set up their own houses in Simhapuri. So they came in the 1971. Saheb family is among them. Simhapuri was then a wilderness, and that period of time in 1971, this place was looked so wild. It still is, but it is not longer empty. In structures of mud with roof of tin and tarpaulin. Now here tarpaulin means tirpal, and now they have made their houses with mud as well as tin and tarpaulin. Devoid of sewage. Devoid means without. But in these areas where they are living, where they have set up their small houses, they are out of sewage. There is no sewage, no drainage or running water everywhere. Live 10,000 rag pickers in that period of and that place. They have lived here for more than 30 years without an identity, without permits, but with ration cards. They that get their names on voter list and enable them to buy a grain. Food is more important for survival than an identity. Now here, what the writer is saying, when the writer got a chance to visit their places where they live, so it was so unfortunate to see that the people are enforced, people are so poor. In such type of conditions, they are suffering. They are living in a mud house, a tin house, which is, you could imagine that in the winter season, how much cold they feel, or in the summer season, how much heat they get from the scorching sun. And even when the raining season is there, so the water spread everywhere, or even whenever they use water for their household works, so there is no any proper system of drainage or sewage, so the water spread everywhere. And if the water is stored everywhere or a particular place, then many diseases can be spread out from this water, because of different bacteria emerge from it. And now they have very harsh conditions where they have to get together in each and every day, and more than 10,000 rag pickers are living in these critical conditions, and they have lived here for more than 30 years without an identity. They do not have any identity. They have been living here for 30 years, and in the name of identity, they have a ration card. And how they got this ration card? First, their voter ID card was made just because of that they have also rights to vote, to choose their favorite person or favorite candidate who can give them justice, who can give them facilities. So, and on this voter ID card, they just made the Russian card on the behalf of Russian cards. They could get a cheap quality that they can get the grains, the rations in a cheap rate. It is the help just because of Russian cards. And this is their, and why, what is their reply about the identity? Identity is not important than food. Food is more important for survival. If at the end of the day we can feed, if at the end of the day we can feed our families and go to bed without an aching stomach. Aching stomach means empty stomach or paining stomach. Now here, if we have food for the dinner, so we could sleep a very soundful, we could have a rest, or we could have a soundful sleep. Otherwise, if we don't have food, then we have to go to bed while our stomach get a lot of pain. If the food is not, if we don't get food, then definitely we have many problems while sleeping. The food is very important to make our body healthier. Or work, then we can work in the next day. We would rather live here than in the fields that gave us no grain. So it is better to live here, because if we live in our fields, in our Dhaka where we came from, and there is no grains, there is no food. Say a group of women in tattered saris, when I asked them why they left their beautiful land of green fields and rivers. So when I asked them, why have you left your own birthplace, your native place, which is full of river and greeneries, you have fields. So they said that if they do not come, there is no grain, there is no food, just because of too much storms they have to face, and that is the problem, they have to leave their places. And this was the reply given to her by a number of ladies who were in tattered sarees. Tattered means their clothes were torn, or many holes were there in their outfits, in their attires. Wherever they find food, they pitch their tents that becomes transit homes. So in the search of food, so they move from place to place, and whenever they find a proper source of getting food, they set up their home. It is known as transit home. Transit home means that which can take from one place to another place. Where right now I am here, it is not transit home because it is shifted. It can be destroyed, but it can be taken from one place to another place. And next line is, children grow up in them, becoming partners in survival. And survival in Simhapuri means rag pickers. So whenever we give birth to our children, they become the friends, they become partners. And here partner means working as a rag picker. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions, the part of a fine art, and before many years, it has been observed that the rag picking work is a good quality of work. Through the years, garbage to them is gold, and these children who are working as a gold, as a rag pickers, for them garbage is gold. For them, it is their daily bread, a roof over their heads. Even if it is a leaking roof, but for a child it is even more. And now here, that gold is what for them? The gold is that if they were able to find as much as plastic, as much as the waste material, not in a kind of a food, let me tell you a story about same happened in Delhi. You know, in Delhi, definitely in near the outskirts of the Delhi, especially near the Nawada, especially near the Madhuban Chowk, just if we go straight towards the outskirts of the Delhi, there is a big statue of God Krishna. Here you could see, if you know that there is a place, a very big spreaded place, hectares, miles of hectares spread a place. And just beside that, there is a colony where poor people are living, as low community people are living, or poor people are living, just beside this big mountains of garbage. The whole, actually there are 3-4 locations where the garbage of whole capital city, whole Delhi city garbage put in 4-5 locations. That whatever the garbage comes through in each and every house of Delhi people or Delhi residents, the municipality, they just put this whole garbage in a particular place, and these particular places have been converted into a mountain, a big stack of garbage, a big dumps of mountain, and it looks like a big rock mountains, but it is actually made by garbage. So what happens, actually lack of awareness, lack of education, lack of using technical mind, what happened, whatever the collection of garbage, the garbage collector take from your house, or when we throw our garbage, this is the just lack of humanity, just lack of mindset, that whatever we have collected the garbage in the dustbin, we have only one dustbin in our house, whether it is a one-story house, two-story house, people generally have one set of bin. They put there all the dust, whether it is a liquid, whether it is a iron, whether it is a blade of iron, whether it is a juice, rotten fruits, chapatis, any gravy, any kind of paper, plastic, we put it at one place. And what they did, the transporter who just collected the garbage, what we did, we just throw the whole bucket, whole bin into his trolley, into his small truck, and this truck, without any filtration, he just dumped in this garbage. And what happened, after a long period of time, a little bit chemicals, actually the whole garbage started rotten, and due to rotten, a little bit chemicals start following from each and every part of the garbage dumps. And this chemical is so polluted, it stink a lot. Those people, it is very critical, such type of chemicals which comes through a form of liquid, it is very painful, very diseaseful for those people who are living at the neighboring of these dumps. These dumps can spread a problem of high blood pressure, asthma, weak eyesight, many problems can get such type of these. And these mountains, and whenever also, every time you could see, if you get the chance to visit Delhi, that they started, it takes a little time to get fire, because it's a piece of garbage, there are many paper, there are many plastic, so it takes a few seconds to spread everywhere, and the smoke also contaminate whole the nature as well as whole the atmosphere, and people suffer from. That's why the Delhi is among the most second or first city in the world which is too populated, too contaminated to take the breath. And it is said that if you spend a one day in Delhi, it means that the person had almost consumed or smoked for 8 cigarettes a day. So that much pollution get in yourself, that much smoke comes in your lungs. So that is very harsh condition, but it's reality. So this is the whole condition about the, and also people are working there, people are living there, and the government is not taking a good initiative to get the solution, because in the whole world, America, USA, British, Russia, they have also garbage problem, but they sort out. Even it is said that this garbage can be recycled, and we can get plastic. Even by this garbage, man can produce electricity as well. So there are many things which can be developed by this garbage, but what is need to understand, that human need to understand that awareness program should be installed everywhere, in television, in a form of advertisement, that the people should have a different beans as a garbage that they can put. If the garbage is little bit liquid type of, they store in different bean. And if there is a form of a paper or a form of a plastic, they put it in different. And if there is a blade or something, something is bad, so they just put it in a different box of a bin. So this type of awareness program should be happened, that this problem can be shorten out. It can be go for a long lecture, so I don't want to go in lectures. I want to stay with the chapter. Just be with it. I sometimes find a rupee, even a 10 rupees note, Sahib Singh. His eyes a silver coin, his eyes lighting up. When you can find a silver coin in a heap of garbage, heap means a stack, a dump of garbage, you don't stop scouting, for there is a hope of finding more. So if we can get a 1 rupees coin, 2 rupees coin, even a note of 10 rupees, then we have a such type of mindset to find out more and more thing inside the heap of garbage, whether it is too stinky, too dirty. They do not care about it. Their work is to find out as much as important thing from this garbage, just because of the hope. It seems that the children, garbage has a meaning different for what it means to their parents. Just forget about the parents. For us, garbage is different, and garbage for rag pickers is different. Both difference is their mind. We think it's a piece of junk, it's a piece of rubbish, but for them, it is a piece of food. It is a piece of their better life. As much as they can have the garbage, they can look for garbage, they could have the roof could sustain on their head, they could have food at proper time. So many things depends on this business. And for them, is garbage is different. For their parents, it's different. For children, it is a wrapped in wonder. For the elder, it is mean of survival. So here, for them, for children, it is a kind of a wrap of wonder, that any kind of things can be explored, can anything, any type of things can be come in a piece of garbage. But for the elders, it is a piece of survival, that if they work, if they find out something, if they daily go on work, so it means that they can survive their life in such harsh conditions. One winter morning, I see Sahib standing by the fenced gate of a neighborhood club, watching two young men dressed in white playing tennis. I like the game, he hums. So what happened one day, the writer was wandering just near the surrounding area, when she found the Sahib was standing behind the fence, behind the wall. He was just staring. The two players were playing tennis, and he replied that he liked this game a lot. He hums, content to watch it standing behind the fence. Content means he was so satisfied to see their performance, to see how beautifully they are playing the tennis. I go inside when no one is around, he admits. The gatekeeper let him use the swing. Now here, it is a kind of a park, as well as in which the courtyard of tennis was installed, as well as many swings for the children were there. Swing means jhule, so where he can enjoy, where he can ride, get a enjoyment of ride. So just because of the help of gatekeeper who allows him to enter, but especially when there is nobody inside it. So maybe how merciful this gatekeeper could be, how kind this gatekeeper could be, who has a great sympathy towards those deprived children, which we don't have. If we see any deprived child, such type of rag pickers, we just make our different facial expression of hate, of just stay away with them, just we feel that these are the people who are suffering from different disease. They are just not a human, they are just a part of like an animal. So we consider them, but the gatekeeper, how fortunate this person, how kind this person, I had to admire. Sahib too is wearing tannish shoes that look strange over his discolored shirts and shorts. He was in discolored color means that the shoes color and his clothes color were totally dissimilar. They were not matching with the color of shirt and shorts were too much faded, whether the shoes were little bit colorful. Sorry. Someone gave them to me, he say in the manner of an explanation. So he told that I got these shoes that somebody had given me, some player had given me. The fact, actually the reason behind who had given him, just come to the actual fact. The fact that they are discarded shoes means they are abandoned shoes. They are just throw them away. These shoes were not workable. So somebody had thrown them into the streets. These shoes maybe belong to some rich boy who perhaps refused to wear them because of the hole in one of them. Doesn't bother him. For one who has walked barefoot, even shoes with a hole is a dream come true. Now here, maybe a person who had discarded these shoes just because of there is a hole in one of the shoes and he throw it. But for Sahib, this shoes is a very very unique or very specific thing for him, that his dream come true. For him, who this shoes is very important, as he was always living in a barefoot and now he had got a pair of shoes and or sports shoes, that is a dream come true for him. But the game he is watching so intentionally is out of his reach. But that he got the shoes, but the game which he is playing, it is beyond his limitation, beyond his reach, beyond his limitation. As limitation word is used as a okad, but we can't judge people by their appearance. You know, like it is said that there is idioms, don't judge a book by its cover, because the cover which shows, which illustrate, is not inside it, and the cover is so simple, but the inside, the content is so interesting, so important. So never judge a book by its cover, or never judge a person by its cover. The day comes of each and every person or each things. So the whenever a perfect day come, then he might be. So let the beyond the meaning of this, the definitely the meaning of this is it's beyond his limitation, beyond his power. This morning Sahib is on his way to the milk booth. Now after a while, after a short period of time, I again met with this boy whose name is Sahib Alam, and what was I observed that he is on the way of milk booth. In his hand a steel canister. I now work in a tea stall down the road, he say, pointing in the distance. So what he did, when I asked or when I saw him and he replied him, now I am working as a tea seller. I have a steel canister which I put a 3-5 glass of tea and give it to different shops, give it to different persons, and this is my work of today. Now he has left his work, rag picking, and now moved to a different type of work. But actual meaning is that they had to do hard work, they had to do labor work, a low standard of work which is against their rights. It is the exploitation of their rights. He say, pointing in the distance, he was pointing to that in that shop I am working here. I am paid 800 rupees and all my meals, that two times of meals as well as 800 rupees per month I am earning from this work. Does he like this job? I asked. So I asked that about what do you like your job. His face, I see, has lost the carefree look. Now there was so tense, there was so worry, so tiredness, so monotonous face was there. It was not carefree, it was a as when he was rag picking, there was a broad smile every time sustained on his face. But now the smile had disappeared. Now his face is so shrink, his face is so pale. The steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bags he would carry so lightly. And now the writer is saying that his canister, the steel canister seems so heavier than the bag which he used to carry to pick the garbage. So this is the first. This is the part of first story, and now we will move to the second part, which is about the Mukesh and a girl who are also doing different work in different parts of the country. Those name is Mukesh and Savita. So their story we will come to the in different section of the video. Thank you so much to be with me, to have patience with me. But before cutting the story, before switch off the video, I would like to again give you a brief introduction about the first story. That here there is a boy whose name is Sahib Alam, who is working as a rag pickers. And what about the barefoot? The barefoot is that they work without feet, without slippers, without shoes. They just walk each and every streets by barefoot and look for the garbage. Just they collect the garbage, put it into their bags. What they get from the garbage, they might be get a plastic bottle, a steel bottle, even a container of steel, even any kind of discarded things which is could be useful for them. So sometimes they get a 1 rupees coin, 10 rupees coin, and what happened in the next steps, what is trying to say, the life of these people who are rag pickers. She got a chance to visit the Simapuri, and these were the very harsh conditions where they are living. They are living in a mud house, and they are which is made of mud and tin and tarpaulin. And this is their transit home. They can move from one place to another place to search for food. And they came in India in 1971 from Bangladesh, and our Sahib Alam family was among them. So you have to know each and every concept of the story. And at the end, what you have to know about the his desire. His desire was his favorite piece of game, that is to watch the tennis match, which is so favorite for him. He becomes so contentful. He becomes so comfortable to see such performance of those rich people who are playing with each other, such type of tennis boy, where he get shoes as well as. And now at the end, he has worked as a tea sailor. He was working as in a tea stall, bringing the cup of glass in a steel canister to different shops, to different people. And this is his work. But as the writer asked him about his job, does he like his job? Then there was no happiness, there was no joyness, there was no broad smile on his face. And now his face was looking so dull, so unhappy, so pale. And it shows that his canister bag, steel canister, is so heavier than the bag which he used to carry. So this is the all concept of this part. I hope you have liked this video. And now if there is any doubt, you can comment me, you can talk to me in each and every time. Thank you so much, dears.